Did you know that adding chapters to YouTube videos can increase your watch time as well as help get your videos ranked on the first page of Google? TubeBuddy suggested that by simply adding chapters can help your videos appear on the first page of Google search. You can see here that one of my own videos is featured, and underneath Google has added some key moments from my video. Key moments are also clickable, which means that viewers can go directly to your YouTube video, which is incredibly powerful. So in this tutorial, I'm going to show you two ways to add chapters to your YouTube videos. So if you're ready to get started, follow me over to my YouTube channel. So once you've uploaded your video, go right down, scroll down, scroll down, scroll down until you find the section that says automatic chapters. Now, one word of warning, please note that not all of you will have access to these automatic chapters, and even if you are eligible for them, you still might not have access to them if you have an active strike against your channel, or if you post inappropriate content, YouTube will not give you access. So that's one thing to bear in mind. So all you need to do now is place a tick in this box here, go over and save your changes. Now you want to view this video on YouTube, so click there. Now click in the description box, which is greyed out. And underneath you will find chapters. And that was so quick, wasn't it? It took just a matter of seconds to do. The main benefit of using YouTube's automatic chapters is that it is fast. And not only do they have timestamps against the chapters, there is also a handy thumbnail image. So that makes them a little bit more attractive to your viewers. They also look very similar to Google's key moments, which appear if you're lucky enough to get one of your videos featured on the first page of Google search. However, as far as I can tell, you have no control over where to place these chapters, despite what it says in YouTube's help section, but I think this is a fairly recent update. So that is a major downside of using YouTube's own automatic chapters. So if you want more control over how to add chapters to your videos, you might want to learn how to do so using TubeBuddy. If you don't already have a TubeBuddy account, just type this link into your browsers. I will also leave the link in the description box underneath so you can click on it later. Open up TubeBuddy and create an account. Now link TubeBuddy with your YouTube account. Once done, you'll be able to see the TubeBuddy menu in the top right-hand corner of your YouTube Studio toolbar. Now all you need to do is upload a video. So once you've uploaded your video, scroll down to the bottom of the description section and find the clickable TubeBuddy link that says Add Chapters. Click on that to get started. You can reposition this window on your screen, so I'm just going to move it up so you can see it a little bit better. So within this new window, you'll see your video, a video timeline underneath with a playhead, and on the right, you'll find the chapters section. There are three things to note first of all. You must have a minimum of three chapters. All chapters must be at least 10 seconds in duration, and all chapters must have titles. So that's pretty straightforward. So let's begin by naming the first chapter, which starts at the very beginning of your video. And here's a pro tip for you. Since chapters provide a source of metadata and can help get your videos ranked, then make sure you include relevant keywords to each chapter title. So my video is about interactive PDF flipbooks. So let's name this chapter. There we are. And underneath the video, you'll see that the title has been added right here. Next, press play or scrub through the video until you get to the second chapter. So I'm going to stop right there. And you'll see that the playhead has moved to the beginning of the new chapter. Now mark your second chapter by either clicking on this little plus icon here above the timeline, or going over to the right hand side and clicking Add Chapter, and I'm going to do that, and then give your chapter a new title. Now mark each new chapter until you reach the end of your video. That's it. Once you've gone through your video and added all the chapters that you want to, you can do one of two things. You can either copy your chapters to a clipboard, and that includes all the timestamps, or you can just add them to your video. And I'm going to do that by clicking on this blue button here. I get a confirmation from TubeBuddy to say that my chapters have been added to my video's description. I need to click on OK. Now I need to scroll down in the description box to find those timestamps, and they are right at the bottom here. So just for convenience, I'm going to cut them from this section here and add them to the top of the description because it's easier for my audience to view. There we are. That's done, and the final step is to just confirm those changes. So I'm just going to click on save, and I'm going to see those beautiful chapters in YouTube. And here they are. Here's the introduction to flipbooks. There's my second chapter, sign up to flipbooks. There's my third chapter, and so on and so forth. And if I click on this grayed out description section, here are my chapters with all the relevant timestamps. If you want to check out how to create an interactive flipbook, as I mentioned in this tutorial, with Canva, here is the link coming up right now. Also, if you want a free Canva Pro upgrade for 45 days rather than the standard 30 days, you will find a link to that underneath this video. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.